It's Mel from The Morning Show with the good, the bad, and the ugly from this week's Hollywood Intel with Mel. First, the good. Tracy Morgan and his recovery. This time last year, Tracy Morgan was in a wheelchair after a car accident with a tractor trailer. His prognosis seemed so grim. Nothing good seemed like it was going to come out of that situation, and it was really scary. But then Tracy said recently that seeing his two-year-old daughter take her first steps is what got him up and moving. That determination has now seen him getting back to stand-up comedy, which he did last month, hosting SNL. This week, he was part of Foot Locker's Week of Greatness. And I love this story because it just reminds you that even if you face adversity, even when it seems like life as you know it is over, you can still overcome anything and find personal success. So that was the good. Now it's the bad. It's tough to choose which story is the most bad of the week because there was actually a lot of really sketchy stories in Hollywood this week. Between bullying and staph infections and getting egged, there was a lot to choose from. I decided to go with The View. The View received major backlash this week after joking about which eating disorder was better to have, bulimia or anorexia. The consensus was bulimia was better because at least you got to eat all the food.
Womp womp.
Backlash was instantaneous, and within 15 minutes of the show, they had to issue an apology. Candace Cameron Bure said that she has suffered from an eating disorder, so because she's been through it, you know, you have to know that they were just joking. Whoopi Goldberg said that they're all comedians, and sometimes they just go a little bit too far. The trouble is that they always seem to go too far. So that was the bad. Now it is the downright ugly. There was no contest for this story this week. The ugliest story to come out of Hollywood Intel this week was Charlie Sheen's HIV announcement and everything that happened after it. Quick disclaimer, this announcement could have been used for good. Had Charlie Sheen used it to bring awareness to a disease that often has so much stigma attached to it, but he didn't. On Tuesday's Today Show, Charlie Sheen revealed to Matt Lauer that he has been HIV positive for the last 4 years. He said, due to the highly affected cocktail of meds that he's been on, the disease is now so untraceable in his blood system that he's essentially been cured. He also said that while he's had unprotected relations in the last 4 years, all of his intimate partners knew about his status at the time. Many people applauded his bravery for coming out about this. Others were angry. Many of his partners came forward saying that they did not know about his HIV status at the time. And at the time of this recording, at least 6 women are suing him, with my sources saying that there's actually going to be a lot more women suing him to come. Details of a non-disclosure agreement that he forced his intimate partners to sign have come out. And Charlie went on to blame unsavory women for his situation, saying that it was unfair of these women to swindle his kids and his grandchild out of their money. Meanwhile, Charlie Sheen has had a well-documented, well-known drug problem for decades, which probably swindled those kids out of way more money than any of these lawsuits is ever going to. There's still time for this story to turn around, but the way that I see it is the only way that can happen is if Charlie Sheen starts to take some accountability in this whole thing. And that, Capital FM, is the good, the bad, and the downright ugly from this week's Hollywood Intel with Mel. I'll see you next week.